I Pallavi.
I Bhumika.
And I Aditi.
Of 8th are going to present a role play on
the life story of a worldwide famous personality.
Yes, he is Indian.
Also known as the man who draws India.
Hafiz Contractor is an Indian architect married to Pearl Contractor. He was born on 19 June in the year 1950.
He did his graduate diploma in architecture from Mumbai in 1975 and completed his graduation from Columbia University, New York, USA on a Tata scholarship.
Hafiz Contractor commenced his career with T. Kharighat as an apprentice architect, and in 1977, he became the associate partner in the same firm.
Between 1977 and 1980, Hafiz was a visiting faculty at the Academy of Architecture, Mumbai. He is a member of the Bombay Heritage Committee and New Delhi Lutyens Bungalow Zone Review Committee.
He has designed many skyscrapers in India, primarily in the city of Mumbai.
He was awarded the Padma Bhushan in January 2016 by the Government of India.
As of 2019, he is the architect of the three tallest buildings in India, the 42 in Calcutta and the Twin Towers of the Imperial in Mumbai.
This was all about his present life.
After this, looking at his school life as a student would really amaze you.
So now, let's walk into a conversation between
Miss Bela Raja, editor of Sparsh, a newsletter from the Resource Center, the Valley School, Bangalore, and Mr. Hafiz Contract.
This terrible nightmare, only now over the last 4 to 5 years, it seems to have disappeared.
What nightmare are you talking about? And why do you think it has disappeared now?
I used to get continuous nightmares about appearing for a maths examination where I did not know anything.
The physics must have gotten over it. I don't have to think of education anymore, and there is absolutely no time to get nightmares.
Tell us something about your earliest memories in school.
In the first and second year, I was a good student. After I reached the third standard, I simply lost interest from studies.
I used to be interested in
games, running around, playing jokes and pranks on others. I would copy in class during exam times. I would try to get hold of the examination paper that had been prepared and study it.
As I could not remember things which had been taught to me in class. However, later one sentence spoken to me by my principal changed my life. When I approached my 11th standard, the principal called me and said,
"Look here, son. I have been seeing you from day one. You are a good student, but never studied. You have taken care of you till today. Now I can no longer take care of you, so you do it yourself."
He talked to me for 5 minutes.
"You don't have your father. Your mother has worked so hard to bring up, paid all your fees all these years, but you have only played games. Now you should rise to the occasion and study."
I had been a very good sportsman.
I had been the senior champion for so many years.
And also I was the cricket captain. I used to play every game, but that year I did not step out onto the field. I would go for prayers, and all I would do was eat and study. I normally used to copy and get passed, but once I was in SSC, I realized that it was not possible. When I got a second class 50% in my SSC, my principal said,
"Son, consider yourself as having got a distinction."
This is my memory of my school days. I did lots of other things. See, as far as my things are concerned, I can't remember. I forget things very easily. To remember things, I have to see matters as a photograph.
I read a book and I can remember the matter as a photograph, but not through my mind.
That's how it works.
When you were in school and you were not doing well, did your teachers pull you up, and how did you feel?
I never felt of anything being pulled up. I used to be so interested in playing.
I would receive a caning every week.
When you knew that you had incurred the wrath of a teacher by not doing your homework or by behaving badly, when you knew you would get a caning, what was the state of your mind?
State of mind?
Just lift up the hand and they would cane you. It would hurt badly and then I would have to forget about it because I would want to go and play.
You never felt insecure or threatened?
I was just interested in playing and nothing else.
One day I did not want to study, so I created a distraction. For one whole hour, we played Chor Police.
Every Saturday, we were allowed to go into the town to see a movie. So what I would do was
have no lunch and collect money from 40-50 students and run and buy the tickets. Please. On my way back, I would eat to my heart's content. We used to have gang fights and plan strategies.
These things used to interest me more than any academics.
Students used to book my textbooks for the following year because they were almost brand new.
How did you get into the field of architecture?
In the College of Architecture, no one who had got below 80-85% was allowed to enter, and I had only 50%. I wanted to join the army.
I got my admission letter, but my aunt tore it up. My mother said,
"Don't join the police force, just do your graduation."
So I went to Jai Hind College in Bombay.
I was either to take German or French. Though I had studied French for 7 years, I did not know 7 words of French. So I took German. Then my German teacher died. So the college showed me that either I could change my college or take up French. Now who would give me admission in another college? I got admission in Jai Hind by influence. So I thought, okay, I will take up French, and I started learning French.
I learned it from my cousin. She was an architect's wife. I was going to an architect's office to learn French.
Was it then decided that you wanted to do architecture?
Actually, it all happened quite by chance.
In the architect's office, I saw somebody drawing a window detail. A window detail is a very advanced drawing.
Your drawing is wrong. The window you have drawn would not open. Bed with me, and then afterwards he realized that indeed his drawing was wrong.
My cousin's husband was surprised. He asked me to draw a few specific things, which I immediately did.
After that he told me,
drop everything and join architecture.
He went to meet the principal. The principal warned me,
I will allow you to take part in the exams, but if you do not do well, I will not allow you to join.
I got a A+ in the entrance exam, and from that day it was a cakewalk. I never made a plan, but I knew how something would look like from the top. First class first throughout after that. That all this understanding came from what I used to do during school. I had a friend called Bairam Divejam. We used to have competitions between us for drawing forts, ammunition and guns. When I was in second or third standard, one of my teachers, Mrs. Gupta, saw my sketches and told me,
"See, you are bad in everything, but your sketches are good. When you grow up, you become an architect."
That time, but she was right. After I became an architect, I went back to her to tell her.
Why do you think you did not like studies? Was it because you felt you could not cope, could not deal with the curriculum?
I was very bad at languages. Science and geography I could deal with. Math was very bad. I just was not interested. I was studying for the sake of studying. What they taught me today, I would forget after 2 days. I would not bother because there was no application of mind there to begin with.
Did you think that what they taught in school was boring, or did you feel that once you understood the concept of what wasn't taught, you lost interest in the rest of the lesson?
In a boarding school is difficult. Nowadays they have so many tests. Back then whenever we had tests, we used to just copy. The teacher thought that we had done our work.
There is a contention that giftedness and learning disabilities go hand in hand. Do you think this applies to you?
Students from my class who always stood first or second are today doing very ordinary job.
I have come across a situation in so many different places where people used to tell me that their class toppers are doing very ordinary jobs today.
Our lives bad, made us street smart. I think I have learned more by doing on my own what I've done than academics would have taught me.
That is because the personality and skills were there. You were able to find expression in a manner in which you were comfortable with. You defied every rule so that nobody would stop you from doing what you needed to do.
I was interested in other things, like during class if it started raining, I would think of the flowing water and how to build a dam to block it. I would think of the flow of water in the dam and how much water could the dam hold in it. That was my interest of the day. When students lost a button while playing or fighting,
they would come running to me and I would cut a button for them from a chalk using a blade. Discipline in the school was very important, and no student could afford to have a button missing.
student would get a pass dinner with a full neat uniform, and after that it did not matter.
To the present, how do you decide as to what kind of structure you want to give a client?
I look at the client's face, his clothes, the way he talks and pronounces, the way he eats, and I would know what his taste would be like. Relate to people in a way that would be comfortable.
I sketch very spontaneously on a paper on the spot. That paper I give to my people in the office.
You do it instinctively.
Call it instinct, call it arithmetic, whatever. That comes to me like mathematics, putting design, construction, sociology and psychology together and making a sketch from all that is mathematics.
Here we almost come to a full circle.
Where Mr. Contractor has derived his own interpretation of mathematics?
Taking it from a subject he hated to a subject he now loves dealing with.
At last, every child is a potential achiever and is different from other children in his or her learning style and areas of interest.